Hello and welcome to today's session. Yesterday we have seen some examples, and some of the examples where we were considering them as singlets, but they were supposed to be two sets of proton. The first one, C8H6O2. Now here two sets of proton we can always draw a structure C8H6O2. So C8H18, so six sides of one saturation, two sets of proton, one is aldehydic proton and the other one is aromatic proton. So that is first example. C3H8O2 C3H8O2 we have drawn, but that will have two sets. One is methyl proton, the other one is hydroxyl proton. If this is can in deuteratum, deuterated water or D2O, then this will give singlet. Okay. Then the third example, C5H10O. Two sets are possible. I'll just draw the structure over here only. CH3, CH2, C double bond, O, CH2, CH3. So two sets are there. One is methyl, the other one is methylene proton. So those are the three examples which we were solving yesterday, and I thought they are on singlet, but they have mentioned that two sets of proton and all, so that becomes easy. Now C9H10O2, C9H10 and C2H2, we are substituting CH for each. C11H12 and C11H24 minus C11H12. 12 hydrogens are missing. So, 6 sides of unsaturation. So, there are 6 sides of unsaturation. Now, this is peculiar example. Quartet, this is 2 methyls, a quaternary carbon, CH aromatic twice. This is quaternary carbon, once again this is CH twice, this is quaternary carbon. So we have to accommodate one quaternary carbon which is non-aromatic, it seems to be. These are all aromatic carbons, 2 to 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9, that is the account for the carbons. Then depth 1 is given, I think depth 2 is not given. Depth 2 is also there, I will tell that also. Depth 1 is 39, 111 and 135 up. This indicates that they can be CH or CH3. These are quaternary carbon, and depth 2 is also there. Depth 2 is 111 and 135, they are up. That means they are CH, because depth 2 gives only the information about CH. CH2 and quaternary carbons will be absent in, even methyl will be absent in depth 2. Okay. Now we have to accommodate all these carbons, 6 sides of unsaturations, and plus we should have those 2 sets of doublets. So the structure comes out to be like this, N double bond N. Okay. So 3 quaternary carbon, 1, 2, 3, This is 152, which is next to nitrogen. This is 120. This is 97. These are quartet at this, and then the aromatic CH are there. These two are one set, these two is another set. So that is how the structure comes out to be. Now this is nitrogen containing compound, so you have to be careful about the valency of nitrogen, which has to be 3. In this case it is fulfilled. Next example is C5H8O2. Now C5H8O2, two isomers are given over here, A and B. We are expecting two different structures for each isomer, like A and B. These are two isomers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, all 5 signals are there. 1853 up, that means CH3. 125, this is CH2. These are quaternary carbons, and here there is no signal, that means there is no CH. So that is 1. So 168 137 137 and 168, both are quaternary, and 125 down, that is triplet. So this is terminal alkene, it goes without saying. And then we have to accommodate two quaternary carbons. This is one of them. So this looks like 137, this is 125. I'll just put the number over there. And then 1853, 18, let us say this is 18, the methyl attached to double bond. 53 will be OCH3, most probably. 1, 2, 3, 3 we have utilized, fourth carbon, and this is 53, the OCH3 group. And 168 is this one. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So all 5 carbons are assigned. This is down in depth 1, that is methylene. These are quaternary, these are methyls, this is one, the other one is over here. So that is your structure A. Now moving on to structure B. Structure B, once again 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 signals are there. Now here this is CH according to depth 1, and depth 2 is also confirming the same. These two are methylenes, this is probably OCH2, this is quaternary carbon. So it is a isomeric compound, and if we put it this way, CH3CO, then OCH2, and then CH double bond CH2. So this is 130, looks like 14.4. Then this is 60.4, because it is attached to oxygen, and then the reverse conjugation is there. This is 129.3, and this one is 166, the quaternary one. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this looks more or less right. okay. Then the next example. Let us talk about the sixth example, C9H10O2. So C9H20. So 5 sites of unsaturation in this molecule, and if you look at the signal like 3 to 5 to 7 1, like strongest 2. So 1, this looks like an ester carbonyl. 1 2 3 4 5 6, all 6 carbons. So one of them is like it is mono substituted, because this these 2, if you look at this 137 and 172, these are quaternary carbons. 122 128.2 128.3 128.6, these are all ARCH. This looks like OCH2, which is confirmed from here. This looks like methyl. So according to depth 1, it is up, so that is methyl. In depth 2, it is absent, that also suggests the presence of methyl group over there. So we have to deal with a mono substituted ring. So mono substituted ring is there, this one, and then you have to attach CH2O, so that this looks like 22, this looks like 67, then this is 172, the ester carbon, then this is 137, and then the CH are there. So this is alkyl group, so ortho and para would be upfield. So 128.2 looks like this, 128.2, this is 128.3, and meta is 128.6. So that is how the assignment would be, and all these are methyly like methines, aromatic methines, 128.2 128.3 128.6, and this is how the depth 1 and depth 2 will go according to this structure. Okay, then the next one, C6H10O. So C6H14, 2 sites of unsaturation. So from here, if you look at, this looks like carbonyl, this looks like C double bond C, this looks like CH stretching, CH bending rather, and then these are the 6 carbons, 21 28 32 124 156 and 198, and here these are either methyls or methines, and but only 124 is methine, so this is ARCH, and all these 3 are methyl groups. So there are 3 methyl groups, these are quaternary carbons, and proton NMR is also suggesting like these are 1 proton, 6 proton and 3 proton. So that accounts for the 10 protons. So 6 proton looks like 2 methyls, the third one is also methyl, so all 3 methyls are seen here. This looks like olefinic proton, only one, so it is a tri-substituted olefin, it seems to be. So, we have carbonyl group, so I will put carbonyl group over here, and then you got to put one CH is there, so that H I am putting, and then here we have one CH3 that is around 21, and these are two methyls, and depending upon the oxygen, so if it is facing oxygen it is 32, if it is away from the oxygen it is 28, this is 21, this is 5.96, multiplied because this has got long range coupling with both the carbons, maybe coupling is in 1 to 2 hertz, but in high resolution spectrum it will be seen, and that is the structure. Now, before we close, let us see one example, and then or one set, one example is still there. I'll just put one example over here, and we have to differentiate these two by CMR. So how to go about? So in CMR we have two quaternary carbons. Here there are no quaternary carbon, that is one difference, that is the clear cut difference, one can say. Quaternary carbons are here, there are no quaternary carbons, and then you can think of CH are absent in this, only CH2s. Here you got two CH, and the remaining 1, 2, 3 CH2s. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 CH2s. So that is the difference between the two molecules, and you can put the approximate chemical shift for those carbons also, because this is alicyclic and carbon values would be there. Second example is based upon the substitution pattern, and here it is based on the PMR, I would say PMR, this one, and then its isomeric compound is given, that is OMe, yeah. Here 1, 3, 5 pattern is there, 1, 2, 4 pattern is there. So for these set A, set B, I would say in this case set A, set B, see, so three types of aromatic protons are there, here two types of aromatic protons, and if you look at the multiplicity, this will be doublet of a doublet, this will be only doublet, this will be doublet only, so that is 1 to 4 substitution pattern.